So the slide is visible.
Yes,
Yes,
sir.
yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So today we can discuss balance of payment. Yesterday I think I have explained something balance of payment. So today we can go through details about balance of payment. So the contents of your syllabus which covering balance of payments, which consist of concept of balance of trade and balance of payments, equilibrium and disequilibrium in the balance of payments, measures to correct deficit in the balance of payment, devaluation and depreciation, importance of devaluation to foreign trade. So these contents we can discuss. First of all, balance of trade. Value of a country's exports and the values of a country's imports for a given period. So, in international scenario, the country's exports and import transactions are there. So, balance of trade is the component of balance of payments. So, balance of trade is one of the component of balance of payments. Balance of trade is the difference between the value of a country's exports and the value of country's imports for a given period. So balance of trade is the largest component of a country's balance of payments. Sometimes the balance of trade between a country's goods and the balance of trade between its services are distinguished as two separate figures. So balance of trade consists of two elements, the trade of goods and the trade of service. So goods and services are separately accounted in the balance of trade. So goods means export of goods and import of goods. Export of goods means the goods which is exported from India to other countries. Importing means from other countries to India. So that is export of goods. Service means service is invisible item or intangible item. So services which may be exported from India to other country and imported services are also availed by the country. So exports of services and import of services, export of goods and import of goods. So balance of trade is also referred to as the trade balance, the international trade balance, commercial balance, or the net exports. So it's the trade balance, otherwise called as international trade balance, because export and import transactions and export and import of goods and services are part of international transactions. So that the balance of trade is also called as international trade balance. Sometimes it is referred as commercial balance. Sometimes it is called as net exports. Net export means total exports minus total imports are called as net exports. So this is balance of trade. So position of balance of trade in 2019 status, 2019 statistics saying that Germany had the largest trade surplus followed by Japan and China. So as per the balance of trade status, at present Germany has the largest surplus of balance of trade and the followed by second largest export balance to the Japan and the third largest export balance to China. So these are the leading countries which have the export balance, Germany, Japan and China. Export balance means net exports are more, but that country's exports are more than imports. While the United States are the largest trade deficit, you may be surprised. The one of the richest nation in the world, that is United States, America, which had the largest trade deficit because a lot of services they are exporting. You might have heard about that. Many Indian companies, the Bangalore is termed as BPO, hub of the world, Bangalore, Hyderabad. These places working, the people working on for US companies. I mean, US people are the clients of these companies. So business process outsourcing badly influence the balance of trade position. So the US, they will outsource the work due to cheap labor. They can avail the cheap labor facility of India. So their labor cost, if they need to work with the US people, they have to spend more money because US people charging more labor expenses, salaries. So the same time, half of the expenses they can meet with, they can maintain an Indian labor so that they can outsource the work to the Indian people. So the Indian people happily do the work with low wages so that their balance of trade position is weak because of a lot of export of services. So while the United States have the largest trade deficit, even with the ongoing trade war with China beating out the United Kingdom and Brazil. The next is United Kingdom and Brazil. They have also a bad balance of trade position. So the leading nations are balance of trade. Favorable nations are Germany, Japan, and China. And the worst balance of trade countries are US, United Kingdom, and Brazil. Any doubts? Do you have any doubts? So debit and credit items. Debit items, which include imports, foreign aid, domestic spending abroad, and domestic investments. So balance of trade consists two sides, debit side and credit side. It's like a profit and loss account, which consists of debit side and credit side, means like an accounts. So debit side consists of imports, import of goods as well as import of services. Then foreign aid, somebody is trying to join, right? So debit and credit items. Debit items include imports, foreign aid, domestic spending abroad, and domestic investments abroad. So you should learn about the debit items, which consist of import. Import means import of trade and import of service. Then foreign aid. Foreign aid is a part of debit transaction. Foreign aid means when a country borrows money from IMF, IBRD, Asian Development Bank. These are called as foreign aids. These foreign aids are debited in the balance of trade account. And domestic spending abroad. Sometimes the people of our country, they sometimes go for tour purpose and they spend a lot of money in the outside country, visit purpose. So that money constitute part of debit transaction of balance of trade. And domestic investments abroad. Sometimes Indian residents invest money in US markets or United Kingdom market or Japan markets. So there are instruments available, instruments or products, financial products available. So they can invest. Indian people also can invest. So Indian people invest in US stock market or UK stock market, or London stock market. So that is also part of debit items of balance of trade. So these are the major items of debit, which include imports, foreign aid, domestic spending abroad, domestic investments abroad, and credit items, which include exports. Exports of goods as well as export of services, than foreign spending in the domestic economy. Foreign spending in the domestic economy. Foreigners, because tourist purpose, you might have experienced many tourists visiting Kerala, Goa. Means many places of India are the favorite places of the non-residents or tourists. So when they come to our country and they will spend money for the purpose of tourism, they spend money for hotel, they spend money for entertainments here. So that is being credited because we are getting foreign exchange from them. So that is being credited. Similarly, we have experienced that when Indian people visit outside country, that expenses spent by the Indian people are debited in the balance of trade. So when the foreigner comes to India or Kerala, when they spend expenses, that is being credited. And foreign investments in the domestic economy. See, that is a major part of the balance of trade. Foreign investments, sometimes domestic economy, comes up. Then by subtracting the credit items from the debit items, economists arrive at a trade deficit or trade surplus. So there are items which has been shown in the debit side. There are items which are shown in the credit side. So we have to subtract the debit item from the credit items. Always we do that to in the profit and loss account to get the profit. So similarly, credit items from the credit items, the debit items are subtracted, and after that we will get a surplus. Sometimes we will get a profit, or sometimes we will get a loss. Sometimes the credit are more than the debit. We would like to say that profit, if the debit item exceed the credit item, it is called as loss. Similarly, we can have a export or credit items exceed the debit is known as trade surplus. When the debit item exceeds the credit items are called as deficits. So this can be calculated monthly basis, annual basis, quarterly basis. Okay, 6 months basis, we can calculate the balance of trade to understand whether our trade is deficit position or surplus position. You understand? Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So trade deficit and trade surplus. A country with a large trade deficit borrows money to pay for its goods and services, while a country with a large trade surplus lends money to deficit country. So there is a two extreme countries are there. There are trade surplus countries and trade deficit countries. You have already experienced that trade surplus countries consist of Germany, Japan, and China, and trade deficit countries consist of US, UK, and Brazil. So trade surplus countries, they lend money to the deficit countries, and trade deficit countries, they borrow money to pay for its goods and services. So sometimes the trade balance may correlate to countries' political and economic stability. So you might the trade deficit countries are politically, economically stable countries. The trade deficit countries are sometimes the political economy's position is not stable. So the political economic situation have a correlation with the balance of trade position. So some stable countries, their balance of trade position always favorable. Some non-stabilized countries, the balance of payment balance of trade position is weak. So I already explained balance of trade. Balance of trade is one of the component of balance of payment. Now we can have a detailed explanation of balance of payments. So balance of payments is a statement of all transactions made between entities in one country and the rest of the world over a defined period of time, such as a quarter or a year. So balance of trade is one of the component of balance of payment. Balance of payment is a wider concept, and it is a statement of all transactions made between entities in one country and the rest of the world. The balance of trade only consists of the trade of goods and services, but the balance of payment is a wider concept which include the capital, which means foreign direct investment as well as foreign portfolio investment from countries. So balance of payment is a wider concept, and which covers the all transactions, not only trade, but also all transactions made between entities in one country and the rest of the world. So there are two accounts. The current account is the balance of trade. The other account also we have to take into account for the balance of payment. The other account is called as capital account. The current account includes a nation's net trade in goods and services, its net earnings on cross-border investments, and its net transfer of payments. So current accounts, we already discussed, current account is called as balance of trade. The trade in goods and services and net earnings on cross-border investments means some if Indians invest in US market, US markets, in the US stock exchanges, and that time the money invested by the Indians to the US markets are debited in the balance of trade. But if you know that when you invest somewhere, the investment provides some returns. So the returns from the investments are credited in the balance of trade. So the current account, which has been debited the investment, but it is credited the cross-border earnings. So when Indians invest in US market, the total investment is debited in the balance of trade or current account. But the earnings from the investments are credited in the current account. Okay. So then capital account, you might have experienced the foreign direct investment. India has been termed as the foreign direct investment hub of the world. The NRIs are very much interested to invest in Indian stock market because the rate of return provided by the Indian stock market is comparatively high as compared to other countries. And also Indian economy is very stable and Indian companies are performing well. So that within a period of 10 years, it is very safe to invest in Indian market. So that capital account balance is very good as far as India is concerned. Secondary's balance of payments and its net international investment position together constitute its international accounts. Balance of payment and its net international investment position. International investment means foreign direct investment from other countries to India and Indian people investment to other countries. So the balance of payment divides transaction into two accounts, the current account and capital account. Sometimes the capital account is called financial account with a separate, usually very small capital account listed separately. So there is two accounts. Sometimes the balance of payment account is splitted into two parts, capital account and current account. The current account includes transactions in goods and services, investment income, current transfers. The capital account, broadly defined as, includes transactions in financial instruments and central bank reserves. So the trade balance and current account balance. So there are two, it's a line graph and two graphs, trade balance and current account balance. You can find India's position of trade balance from 1992-93 to 2018-19. So you can see that there is a downward sloping curve and some fluctuations, but it has been less, it is all negative. So that means India's trade balance as well as current account balance is negative over a period of time. So we can say that historically India is a trade deficit country. So the trade balance and current account balance. Okay. So I can explain all these things. So So this is a document which has been stated in the RBI sites. India's balance of payment in 2018-19 and assessments. So current account. Current account in the balance of payments covers all cross-border transactions relating to goods and services, trade, receipt and payments of income from investments and unilateral transfers. Unilateral transfers means gift from one country to another country. Sometimes India may give gift to other countries. Sometimes other countries also given gift to India. So when India give to other countries, that is be debited in the balance of payment account. When sometimes other countries giving gift or transfers to India, that is been credited in the balance of payment accounts. So trade in goods, this is the status of trade in goods 2017-18 and 2018-19. You can make a comparison. India's balance of trade in goods, goods and service, goods, service, separate details you will get credit, debit, net. So you can find that the net is negative. That means there is a deficit. And 2018 also the net is negative. That means a trade deficit. So services, fortunately in services we are plus. Goods we are negative. Services we are plus means why? Why the services we are plus? Anybody can give answer. The balance of trade position, services are positive and goods position is negative. Why? I touched this part in my presentation. Anybody can explain? Yes, you can respond. Any answers? Yes or no? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
But you don't have an answer, right? Any answer for this question? Yes or no? Huh? Yes? No answer. Sudhi wanted to say something? Why India's balance of trade consists of two accounts? The goods and service. Goods position is negative over a period of time, but the service is positive. Why? So there is a noise when so Abhijit wanted to say something.
Yeah. Hello, sir.
Yes. Yes.
Sir.
Abhijit, tell.
Can you ask me a question once more?
Huh?
Hello?
Yes. Ah, yes, I can hear you. Tell.
Sir, please say the question once more.
Okay. So, I said the current account, this is the current account position, India's balance of payment, current account position. Current account, I already explained, the goods and services are the major items in current account. So when you compare the items, 2017 and 2018, the amount in US billion dollars, and the goods position, the net is negative. And 2018-19 also negative, but services is positive. So I am asking why, the reason for the difference.
Sir, I think our country provide more services than goods.
Okay, so the reason is simple. India is doing lot of because of the IT services, the clients are from many foreign countries. We are doing some BPO services. I already explained. So due to this factor, the services we are positive, but the total net is negative. Net balance of trade position is negative because of the huge negative effect of goods. Goods, you can find that minus 160, and in 2018-19 minus 180. But 81 is positive for services, and 77 is positive for net effect of services in 2017-18. But the total current account effect is negative due to the huge amount of import of goods from other countries to India. So that is a position of 2017 and 18. You can watch this from RBI's website. So now you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So there is an interpretation is there. Interpretation of this table is there. You can find from the RBI site. And this table already been graphed. You can find the curve. This graph already I have shown. And this about the services. Export growth in export and import of goods. This is goods, and you can find that the export and import in two different colors. Export is green and import is in orange color, and you can find that import is more than export. Okay, so every year import is exceeding because we are in a developing country, so we want some imported goods, so always be importing. But service export growth of major service exporters, export growth of major service exporters, nammala the people of I mean India, this graph shows the country's position of service export growth of major service exporters. In Ireland is a major exporter. Japan is second one. India's also service. You might have experienced that. India's service position is very good. The third one. So the third largest country who exporting services. After that, Singapore, Germany, China. China is, as compared to India, it's lower position. Netherlands, US, France, UK. So this graph shows the country's performance of exporting of services. So this is sourced from WTO and RBI. You can find that Ireland is a major dominant country of exporting services in the world. And after that, Japan, and after that, India, and after that, Singapore, Germany, China. These are the major service exporting countries in the world. So the major export, you might have experienced that software export. I already explained that software export is a major part of India's balance of trade. And this is a sector wise India's trading services, which consist of travel into India for travel purpose, and it has been credited. And 19.5, this is the Indian people who traveled abroad, that is debited, and the net is positive travel. And 2018-19 credit 28.4 and debit 21, and other plus transport can find that is negative. Transport, insurance is positive, software is positive, business positive, financial negative, communication positive. So these are the effect of trading services. Ender services, our position is positive. So visa rejection, H-1B visa rejection rate of major Indian companies. This is a visa rejection rate. It's beyond our topic. We don't need to explain. Then India's primary income account flows. You can visit this website, and I will give the URL of the website. You can visit the site, and next class I will ask some questions. Okay, so you can visit the site and find out the balance of payment position of India in detail, and you can make an understanding of India's balance of payment position well. So next class I will ask some questions on this. So investment income payments 2018-19. This is another thing. Investment income payment, reinvested earnings, dividend to non-resident shareholding. So these are the this is a graph showing investment income payments. Means when foreigners comes to foreigners, foreign income coming to India and the investment, and we need to pay for the interest and the dividends. So there are a lot of graphs explaining the balance of payment position. This is a foreign direct investment position. Foreign direct investment position over a period of time, it is, you can see that it has been increasing. FDI to India, FDI by India. So FDI by India is very low, that is in the red mark, and FDI to India, that means a lot of foreign countries interested in India. So that is a basic fundamental thing of India's balance of payment position. The capital account is very strong. Then country-wise distribution of FDI in India, FDI to India. The, you can find that Singapore is the 2017-18 and 2018-19 comparison graph, and Singapore is the largest country who deposited in India, and Mauritius, US, Japan, Netherlands, UK, all these countries were interested to Indian companies or as well as India. So there are a lot of graphs. We can see this graph and prepare based on this document. And you will get a PDF image, PDF also. You can download and learn India's balance of payment in 2018-19 and assessment. So next class, I will ask questions on this India's balance of payment position on this document. So please download this document and learn it. This is assignment first assignment of international economics, and individually I will ask questions, same something like Viva. Okay, I'm going to wind up today's session. Next class also balance of payment I will continue after. I will ask questions, so any doubts you can ask me right now. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, India's capital account balance is good. But we have a trade deficit. That's why.